تهیه پو پالدیم نب دبلین این گرایش کام تلیت هم تازه بیشتر از برنامه تانا 12-3 نسپری لکل کام ویکند تهیه نسپری لکل کام لایت تهیه پلی کل کام فتیتین بیش اتاو مال فامیلیاری مال محبوب انتا کام که مهمترینی لی انزوم فتیتین ال تاکولیتا ال دوک نسلی تانتن حبو آنا هفنا مستدنین لوم ولک منشتهش نپانایت هفنا اینا ام لوم ل اکام مال لوم مستدنین لی آنا وکی لوم دیجالت ایتو مال لوم ما واحدا منم واحدا من مستدنین لی آنا او ساو کال نبودن raw it-team minuma down in this wara MACC. Laura, welcome back onto the program. Thank you very much.
Nice to be back again.
And we have Monica with us here as well today, who incidentally was here last week but behind the cameras, and so she wasn't seen, but we do have a photo that we can show of her that was taken actually on the first day of work, and maybe we can see the photo so our spectators at home can see that. I'm going to start with you, Monica, because I know that you're extremely nervous, so I want to get the nerves out of you, but now we have this beautiful photo up in front of you. What a lovely photo that was, actually. It's really nice. I should frame that. So, Monica, first of all, what nationality are you?
I'm Czech, so I came from Czech Republic about 2 years ago.
Okay.
And
you saw this article, or you saw this, how did this happen?
So Monica is an actor, but she's also a visual artist, and she just...
Like yourself?
Yes, like me, so we've got a lot in common, actually. But she came across the MACC on Facebook, and she was really interested, and she got in touch with me to find out more. And so I told her a little bit more about it, and then she went and wrote this fantastic article, because she's a blogger as well.
Okay.
She's got a blog called...
It's a hipster Malta guide. I started 2 years ago, and it was a project to kind of explain people what to do extraordinary in Malta, and something artistic and something in culture, and help people connect to each other as well. So I wrote this article about the MACC, and then Laura contacted me, and we found out that we have a really lot of things in common, and we can work together because... I was always interested in arts and culture, and I wanted to be part of it in any way, so that's basically what happened.
Before I ask you some more questions about your blog, for the beneficiary of the people who didn't watch last week, can you give us a quick roundabout MACC again? Yes.
A quick recap. So last week we were here talking to you about the MACC, M-A-C-C, which is the Malta Arts and Culture Club. And we're here to tell people about the crowdfunding campaign, which we told them about last week, and to update everybody. It's going really well.
Great.
So the crowdfunding campaign is designed to raise money to pay for an app through which the MACC, the Malta Arts and Culture Club, will function.
Okay.
So that's what we're doing here.
In a nutshell.
In a nutshell, yeah. And so Monica's actually part of this now, which is great, because when I saw her article, I realised that she could actually explain it in a really... in a really nice way, kind of better than I could, actually. And I thought I need to have Monica as part of the team, you know?
How would you explain it? I mean, what is the MACC to you?
So for me, it's something very personal because, as I said, I'm a self-taught artist myself. And for me, it's beneficial thing for anyone who is interested in arts and culture. It doesn't necessarily mean that... You have to be professional, you can just be enthusiastic and in love for art and culture, and then you benefit from it. So it's about connection with people, it's about socializing, it's about networking as well, and then it's about benefits, because you can have a lot from it in a way of benefits as like...
So the benefits that Monica's talking about are, apart from being part of actually a network, which is what this is all about, it's about connecting people, being a member of this and joining, which you can actually do through the campaign, you can get benefits such as, anything that's related to the arts. So it could be deals on theatre tickets,
okay.
Discounts on your art materials, which is great for us because, you know,
we know
have
how expensive that can be as well.
Exactly. In fact, that's how it started because, you know, we spend a fortune on our materials.
On your materials, so you needed it was something which you saw the benefit of.
Yeah. So the idea is that as a group, collectively, you kind of have purchasing power in a way, but it's also really good for, you know, the art stores and people like that come on board to provide these discounts because they get promotion for what they're doing.
And so there are almost three beneficiaries. There are the people who are actually artists like yourself.
Yes, exactly.
There are the people who are home, which also want to be spectators and watch. Mm-hmm. And then there are also the commercial entities who want to be part of this, if I'm understanding correctly.
You've got it in a nutshell. It's a win-win. There are no losers. Everybody benefits from this because we've been working with Professor Richard England, and he described it really well. He said, one and one does not equal two. So when you come together, the whole is greater than the sum of its parts.
The numbers.
That's what it's all about.
Yes, you're much stronger as a number like that. Yeah. So back to your blog, Monica. Yeah. What made you write about Malta? Had you been here already? Did you just hear about Malta?
No, it's... Basically, I started to write a blog in Czech Republic. It was something similar. And then when I moved here, I just realized that there is something missing for people who are interested in something different. So I decided to I was already discovering places which are a bit hidden maybe, or like people don't know about it. And so I had this need to share it with people, what to do in Malta, where to go in Malta, and how to find interesting people to network with. So that was the idea behind the blog. I started it, but I didn't really have so much time for it as I wished because of my full-time job. So then, now I'm so happy I can do something with Laura because this is something I love and I can share my passion for arts and culture much more than I ever could.
What is it that you enjoy doing most, Laura and Monica, and the arts? And Camille, I know you're a visual artist. Is there something you really have a passion for?
Well, I think from Monica's perspective, she's a brilliant writer, and English is not your first language. And she just puts things so eloquently. So you get a chance to do that, which is what she was doing before, and the social media. But from my perspective, I just love being in this environment. I love meeting people like you and people who are in theatre, artists, musicians. We were here last week with Michaela. It's just a really enjoyable job.
Because one thing you did mention is the networking aspect of all of this, which is you really you cannot ever underestimate that, how powerful it is when you find a platform as artists to come together and collaborate. And in the art industry, I feel it is really, it's a lot of the fun, I feel, from my personal experience as well, just collaborating with different people. It's something I enjoy doing a lot as well. So moving forward with the MACC, people out there who want to collaborate, who want to become part of this movement almost, because that's what it is, what can they do?
So the campaign's still running. It'll be running until the end of the month. So actually, by contributing to the campaign, people join. So people become part of this.
Whether they're an artist or just a spectator or a commercial entity at this stage.
This is for anyone. Anyone at all who kind of goes out to the theatre, who goes out to the cinema, who is interested in photography, all of these things. So we all do it every day, right? So it's for everybody. But you can actually become part of it. You can become a member through the campaign. So you contribute and you become a member.
So there's a crowdfunding which people need to log on to remind me where?
So it's ZAAR.com. And our project is called MACC.
So you just find it over there, and if you want to contribute to it, then eventually you can. Just to give a quick briefing in Maltese, li qed ngħidu huwa li ħaj inħoloq app application li tkun tista' tniżżel fuq l-smartphones tagħkom jew fuq it-tablets, u fuq dan l-app ħajkollkom jekk inti artist, ħajkollok aċċess biex tagħmel collaboration ma' artisti oħra, jekk inti persuna li tħobb tara l-arti u l-kultura tista' jkollok it-tarif ta' fejn inti tista' tmur biex tara dawn l-affarijiet u jkollok deals tajbin u discounts fuq l-attivitajiet li jkun hemm hemmhekk, u jekk inti xaħat li inti dbiħ l-affarijiet għall-artisti, naf l-instrumenti, il-żeba, il-canvases, inti jemmek u kolħal kollok il-reach ovvjament għal din il-pjattaforma ta' dawn l-artisti. L-app għadu ma sarx u għalhekk Laura fl-inkima Monica għadin għawek biex jitkellmu fuq dan il-crowdfunding. So to explain, crowdfunding it's basically a platform where people can donate or contribute their money and be one of the first members to actually help build this app, is that right?
Yes, so it's rewards-based crowdfunding. That's what this is all about. So it's not like you're donating something and then that's the end of it. The contribution that you make to the crowdfunding campaign makes you a member. Okay. So you have an annual membership, which gives you all of the benefits of being a member. Plus, you get to be part of this really interesting network of like-minded people. With a lot of energy and buzz behind it, and you're supporting the arts as well, so it's
When are you hoping to launch this app?
So the app will go. good question. So the app will go into development shortly after the campaign, and it will probably take about 3 months, 3 to 4 months, and then we'll have a soft launch and then a big public launch later on in the year.
What are the type of people you're finding at the moment looking to collaborate? Can you give us some examples or names of people who are actually collaborating at the moment?
You mean the merchants themselves?
Yes, or even artists themselves, as in what types of artists?
So at the moment, we're at the stage where we have our supporters who come through the campaign, but mainly we're dealing with the merchants. So people like art shops, music stores, theatres, people who offer creative courses, people who provide printing and framing services. Artists use these all the time. So anything at all that's to do with perhaps photography or something arts related, computer equipment. So we're dealing with the merchants who provide these things. Mm-hmm. So what they do is they come on board, we promote what they're doing, and they give members discounts on their products, essentially.
Because once you start mentioning things, you realise you don't really stop, do you, with the amount of people involved in the commercial world who are directly related to the artists and the culture world in general. And what about the actual members as artists themselves? Are you getting artists from different walks of life, or is it just visual artists, or is it just singers? I don't know.
So the members don't necessarily have to be artists or musicians or performers. Liquid. This is just the general public, you know, anyone at all who has ever bought a book, you know, this is about literature as well. So it's members of the public, people that we know, people who've seen our TV slots, like with you last week.
For the simple reason, like we said, you're more than welcome. It's an app which is somewhere or other, I think, going to touch everyone's, because everyone likes or more than contributes, touches the art world in some way or other, whether it's reading a book, like you said, or whether it's watching a film, going to the theatre. So, I mean, it's what life is all about at the end of the day.
Exactly.
Quality of life, I feel, is all about. What would life be without arts and culture? So, Monica, your ambition now moving forward, are you here to stay? Are you looking forward to seeing this app develop? What are your plans?
I'm super excited. I'm very happy this happened, and I'm going to support this project as much as I can, because I think this is what we were missing in Malta, because we already had a lot of art groups and groups with creative people. You know, you can find a group for filmmakers, you can find group for visual arts and so on, but we didn't have this
collective.
Exactly, that's what is it about, you know, we want to collect all these people together, so we have one big application, and it's easy, it's people friendly, it's very useful for everyone who doesn't want to spend time searching. You know, it can be difficult when you search for stuff like open calls for artists. If you are looking for a job, for example, in arts, it can be very difficult and time consuming. So that's what we are trying to do, and I'm very happy for it, and I hope it's just going to go well.
I'm sure it will. Laura, Monica, thank you very much for once again being with us here today.
Thanks.
I look forward
us.
To seeing this develop, and maybe once it finally is, we can also meet again and talk about and keep on talking about it, because I think it's a great thing what you're doing here.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Good luck. And your blog again is?
Hipster Malta Guide.
Hipster Malta Guide. Have a look.
Thank you again.
Senaddu għal-pawza għazira ta' reklami bqaw maħna jekk iġobkom nfakkarkom ukoll li fl-aħħar tal-programm ikollna l-kompetizzjoni ta' kull ġimgħa biex hekk nibdew il-ġimgħa fuq nota tajba l-kompetizzjoni ta' 50 euro mill-Park Towers u nfakkarkom ukoll li matul din is-skeda kull nhar ta' tnejn qed insaqsu mistoqsija biex issemmu wieħed mill-UNESCO Heritage Sites li għandna f'Malta ibgħatu fuq il-Facebook page tiegħi l-risposta wieħed mill-UNESCO Heritage Sites li għandna f'Malta u intom tistgħu terpu 42-inch smart TV grazzi għall-iskan. Hemmhekk huma tagħmlu itlu fuq il-Facebook page tiegħi qafsu like hemmhekk ibgħatu messaġġ u għajdu li x'inhu huma wieħed mill-UNESCO Heritage Sites li għandna f'Malta. Fl-aħħar ta' skeda aħna mbagħad intellgħuha bil-polza u naraw min ħajkun irrebaħ proprjament dan il-television 42-inch grazzi għall-iskan. Se naddu għal-pawża qasir ħafna ta' riklami nerġgħu nkunu magħkom fl-imkien mad-dentist Dr. Jean-Paul de Mayo. Ibqgħu magħna.